Thanks for joining us here at Studio 73. Some local faces popped up on national TV last weekend. Deval Patrick, Mitt Romney, and Scott Brown all spoke about health care and the Obama administration's rough rollout. Jacqueline Cashman takes a look at who was most effective.
Here in Massachusetts, he did the right thing on health care.
President Obama's recent trip to Boston sent Bay State politicians straight to the Sunday talk shows, including Obama's 2012 presidential rival and former Massachusetts Governor Mitt Romney.
I think the key thing that the president is trying to get away from, and that is that he told people they could keep their insurance, and that was not the truth.
Mostly quiet since his failed presidential bid, Romney might have been the most effective speaker to take the president to task on his recent rollout of the Affordable Health Care Act. Obama's buddy, Governor Deval Patrick, was up next on NBC's Meet the Press to defend his friend and political partner.
If the website is permanently flawed, we've got a serious problem. But we've got a rollout problem. It's been, what, 3 or 4 weeks?
Ousted U.S. Senator Scott Brown was voted into office as a referendum on Obamacare.
Here, as you remember, I was sent here as one of the reasons to stop Obamacare.
Brown joined Fox's Sunday roundtable.
The reason my blood was boiling, because they're basically misleading the voters. I'd say they're lying about what's fact and what's fiction.
Apparently, the president is trying to rewrite history when he should be rewriting this health care law. For Press Party, I'm Jacqueline Cashman.
Okay, so Jacqueline, you argued that Mitt Romney was most effective on Meet the Press. Why was that?
I think because he has not been out in the public very much since he lost his presidential run. So coming out now regarding health care, something that he was able to champion in Massachusetts, he could speak to it, and I think he was most effective for that reason.
And even though David Gregory pulled up Mitt Romney saying back in 2006 what he said, saying that this would be best for the whole nation, do you think that still makes him...
Well, I think there are partial words there. I think what Governor Romney was saying is that this is a model for the other states to follow, not to come down from the federal government. I think that's what Governor Romney was saying.
You disagree, Tina?
Listen, this healthcare issue is Pac-Man. It's going to eat up the budget if we don't deal with it. And do we effectively? And what's happened here is the rollout of a website and the rollout of the program are together. The website screwed up. The technical background and all that stuff is messed up. The real question is, should people in the United States actually have health care? I think Governor Patrick did an effective job. He was fair and balanced. I use that word. Because he did say, listen, I've been telling the president that you have to get out there and actually sell this. And that's one of the components that I think is really critical. And they should have made these stops, like they did a couple of weeks ago, here a lot earlier, I think, versus waiting till it was a reactionary aspect of it. So. Mm-hmm.
We talked last week about how it was clear that President Obama was trying to draw the connection to Mitt Romney back in 2006 because he had his event in Faneuil Hall. Do you think that's backfired now that Mitt Romney is coming out and speaking about it?
I don't think it's backfired. I just think that the president, you know, you say that, the website's bad, but the plan is good. Well, if you can't get access to the plans, then the plan's bad. So until that gets fixed, we can't really talk about anything until we actually can get on to the plan. So whether it was good or bad, I say, you know what, Obama, get out there as much as possible and talk, because the best thing you can do is talk. The worst thing you can actually do is have any action. So just keep on chatting and just don't come up with any more laws
but
while you're in
the
office.
The worst part about the rollout, and this is where the Republicans screwed up, the rollout, the website went live, and the government was shut down.
So that's interesting. So the website was a disaster because the government was shut down? Well, no, it's because the president chose the wrong company to build this website.
But you're not understanding. By shutting down the government, some of that blame, thankfully, went on to the Republican Party for shutting down the government. Do I think there was a failed implementation when this happened? Yes. Do I think there was failed implementation? I was in the healthcare industry when Medicare Part D was rolled out, when you had elders who were told to go online and sign up for a healthcare program, and only 20% of people over 65 use computers. That's a problem too. But I think the screw up there was actually helpful relative to Republicans shutting down the government at the same time as this rollout happened. We would have gotten, as Democrats, we would have taken it even more on the chin.
John McCain was right. We should not have shut the government down over the healthcare thing. But what's happened here is that, you know, the majority of the majority of the people in the United States, whether Democrat or Republican, agree that everybody should have health care, affordable health care. Now, but the problem now is that you've got a program that you could argue was sold on a lie. I think people from both sides could argue that point. And what I'm saying is now is that, and I think you've got bipartisan people on both sides saying we should step back and fix this thing before we have a full implementation and a full rollout.
Before we talk about get out on a whole healthcare battle, we don't want to go too off topic. Are reporters asking the right questions right now to people? Are they getting what
people need to hear? It's very funny you ask me that you bring up that question, because this morning in morning meeting we had Don Berwick on our show, who played a major role in coming up with this healthcare law. He worked for President Obama, and we asked him, was President Obama lying to the public when he said, if you like your coverage, you can keep it? And you know what his response to us was? You're asking the wrong question. That was his response to us, and he's running for governor here in Massachusetts.
What was the right question?
The question is, we should not be focusing on the problems of Obamacare. We need to be, or the Affordable Health Care Act. We should be focusing on how great it's going to be that everybody's going to be covered. And I said, well, what about the 5 million people? That's not the right question. You have the wrong focus in this interview.
Thanks for watching Press Party. Make sure to stay on BostonHerald.com. Our next segment is just a click away.